So today, I'm going to share with you this beef stew marinade thing. The Clubhouse slow cooker marinade beef stew thing. But I'm not going to be making it in the slow cooker. I'm going to be baking the beef stew. And I'm not going to be really showing you the recipe. It's the exact same recipe, the method, as in my baked beef stew recipe. You can find it in my video upload. Alright, so I've uploaded that recipe already. So I'm just gonna show it to you when I'm mixing in this packet in the beef stew, and I'm gonna be baking it. So we're gonna be back for the taste test, and I'll see you guys soon. And also, this might be normal for some of you guys to use this product already, but this is my first time trying this out. So we'll be back and I'll show you the finished stew today. So now I've assembled everything into the pot to bake the beef stew in. So now I am ready to add in this seasoning for the beef stew. And I forgot to mention one thing. I looked through the ingredients at the back of this packet, and apparently there is a red wine powder in it too. So if you're not too caring about this red wine stuff, you might not like it, but I haven't tried this product before, so I don't know. So now I'm going to cut open this packet, and then I'm going to sprinkle it in everywhere, and then I'm going to have to it smells pretty good too. And I'm going to add in 1.5 cup of water. Just simply sprinkle it everywhere. Make sure the entire packet is used up. So I am going to give it a, you can see the brownish color of the powder. I'm going to use a spoon to stir it around first. Alright. Make sure the meat and stuff gets coated nice with the seasoning. I can already see the everything that gets touched by the powder is starting to change color already. And I seasoned the beef a little bit with the salt as before I browned the meat, because you want your meat to have some nice flavor too. So this is what this stuff looks like. It turned into like a syrupy, looks like a dark syrup. Look, like a glaze. That's what it looks like when it came into contact with the meat and stuff. So now in goes the water. Alright guys, so this will go covered and bake for 375 degrees or 2 hours. So we'll be back and I'll show you what this product looks like. So I'm not sure how it will work if it's in the slow cooker, because I followed exactly their instructions, and I even added a little bit more water than they told me to in the instructions, because the instructions says 1 1/3 cup of water, and I added 1.5 cup of water, and the water, it just soaked everything up by itself. So this is what the finished up stew looks like, and the dark color came from the powder by itself. So there's not much liquid left in the stew. So this was the original packet here. And yeah, I'm gonna serve you up a bowl and we're gonna have a taste now. So here's my bowl of stew here, using that clubhouse stuff. So let's have a taste. Here's a piece of beef for you guys. Lost Girl. New season premieres Sunday, November 10th at 10, only on Showcase.
Here to clean the color. No, that's nasty. Not anymore. Scrubbing bubbles, toilet cleaning gel prevents large scale buildup and rings with every flush. Nice work.
Now, if you only put the seat down.
It's actually not too bad. But I couldn't really make out the flavors for the seasoning packet though, but when I said I might thicken it up with some flour, it naturally thickened up itself. I did not do anything at all to it. I only gave it a stir halfway through the cooking, and then the liquid, it just all absorbed by itself, but and I don't really taste any red wine, but the ingredients listing taste says it's the red wine powder in the flavoring. And I only added a bit of salt and pepper and stuff to the beef to season the meat. It's actually not bad because I think this is pretty good because with a little bit of chopping and stuff for the vegetables, and you get a very flavorful stew. And I guess this is exactly the way a beef stew is supposed to taste like. And the seasoning packet for the beef stew is actually not too salty. I actually quite like it, actually. So, if you haven't tried this stuff before, I recommend it to give it a go. And yeah, it makes a really nice and flavorful beef stew, and it gives it a nice rich and dark color. It gives it a nice tinge. Can you see it? It gives it a nice dark color. Like that. But yeah. But don't forget to season your meat though. So I recommend the seasoning stuff for you guys to try it next time when you feel like beef stew. And until next time, I'll see you again in the next video. Thanks for watching.